Good morning, guys. I tell you what, I don't know what's wrong with people this morning. I had a Harley passing me. You know, a Harley's an easy rider. You just take it easy and be calm. Enjoy your ride to work and all. But this dadgone Harley back here, back on down the road, I wish I'd had my camera on. He passed me, passing everybody. I'm like, where are you going,
man? 1 mile, turn left at I-65 South, Nashville.
And then we got a truck up here. He's passing everything like crazy. It's like, where are you going? There's traffic in front of you. Everybody was already running 60 mile an hour, and he's passing everybody. Well, the guy in front of me, he started to speed up, not let him over. It was kind of funny. But, yeah, I don't know what's wrong with people this morning. Well, he is turning right up here, so I guess he's got to be at work at 6. Well, it's 5:58, and I guarantee you that's what's going on. But, come on, people, get out of bed. Wake up. Anyway, that's my rant for the morning. Let's cap that on so y'all can see the construction. Now this is my own personal massager up here. Listen to this. Hang on.
Turn left at I-65 South, Nashville.
What? That thing is shaky to death right there. The rumble strips. They moved us all on the rumble strips. Oh, me. Yeah, they tearing that bridge out and got us narrowed down. Took a whole side off of it. Yeah, here we go. Well, I ain't gonna try to race that truck. I'm gonna be easy rider this morning, like I said that Harley guy needed to do.
Continue straight for 25 minutes to exit 98, Ellington Parkway, US 31 South.
You know, I like my ways and all, but sometimes she just don't shut up, does she?
She'll watch speak. Out, construction on road ahead.
See what I mean? Sometimes she'll speak at the worst times. I get so mad, but I'm sitting there thinking, well, dummy, turn it off. You already know where you're going, why you need ways. Well, I use ways for traffic reports and cops and stuff, and detours. So just part of it, I guess. But anyway, hey, I tried out the new car wash that just opened up in Portland. And switching lanes around this guy with this yellow flashy light going, because what he's gonna do is slam on his brakes and go in that construction zone. You don't wanna be behind those guys. But yeah, they finally got us a good car wash in Portland. Rolling Wash, I think it is. And I went ahead and got the monthly subscription to it. And you know, as everybody knows, you can go through it all you want. Well, one time a day. Used to, some of the other ones you could go through 4 or 5 times a day if you wanted to, but like everybody else, they tightening up a little bit, I guess. It did a pretty good job. When I saw them building that thing, I said, I ain't gonna wash my truck till they open it. And tilt this camera down just a little bit. Might shouldn't have done that, you see my old belly. But anyway, year later, I finally washed my truck. And it did pretty good, actually. I mean, there's a few spots, you know how they'll miss, but I plan on running it through there every day, if nothing else, you know, 3 days a week anyway. I mean, I come home and it's like right there on the corner, just go in, come around, do what I gotta do, right back out, you know. What, take me about 8-9 extra minutes probably, so. Yeah, man. So, my truck gonna be all nice and shiny all the time now. But yeah, we got a lot going on at work right now. Need more help, that's for sure. So y'all know anybody who wants a job, send them my way. We could use about three more people, but can't find anybody who wants to work. I had a young fella working up there. He's 21 years old. Man, I'm telling you, this newer generation, they can't even wake up in the mornings. I mean, 10, 15 minutes late every day. Sometimes 2.5 hours late. And sometimes later than that, it has been known. But
watch out, construction on road ahead.
But yeah, I don't know what's wrong with people this day and time. I was raised to get up, get out of bed, and get to work. And I'm glad I'm that way. And I got good work ethics too. And you know, you can't make it in life if you don't work. So I just make it a point. I'm an hour early for work every day. I've always been that way. And of course I had to when I was a youngster, because I used to ride into work with Dad. Dad always went to work an hour early. So naturally I had to, which it was fine. It was fun to me. But yeah, I got a lot of work to do. Had one of my guys out this week for 2 days. I had some big round slings to do. So I was out in the shop. I spent half a day, 2 days, making it. And I'll have a video on that. It's an all right video. Of course, making round slings and washing it's kind of long and boring, but I'll chop it up, maybe we'll speed it up. But yeah, guy called, I think it was on Monday, I think. He says, y'all make round slings? Yes, sir, we do. And he told me what he wanted. He needed some 53,000 pound round slings. He needed four of them. He's picking up 90,000 pound. I said, yeah, I can handle it. I said, when you need it? He says, well, I got to have them Thursday. And I was like, boom. I was like, well, I said, if you got to have them, I'll make it happen.
Watch out, construction on road ahead.
Getting crazy through here. Everybody's tapping their brakes and stuff. It's like, there's caution lights up here. This guy, he's fixing to dart off the highway here, so let me be careful. But, so yeah, I said, I'll make it happen. I said, I don't know how I'm gonna make it happen, but you don't worry about it. You'll have your slings. And that's the way I work. People need it now, I get it now. And we always seem to do it. Now, I don't know who the next person call gonna be mad because they ain't got their stuff, but if he calls, I'll say, get on it right now. We'll get you taken care of. Sorry about that, you know. You tell them what they want to hear, and you do what you told them you're going to do. And people appreciate that. They'd rather have honesty. So, and we got a lot of stuff going out. Excuse me. Got a lot of repairs, 3/4 quads. Got all kinds of stuff I got to get rode up today. People gonna start calling me on that, and some already have on some, but I knocked them out real quick. Quoting another company, some personnel platforms to go on forklifts. I hope to get that, and this particular company, I get everything I quote them. Same one I sold them big old swivels to in another video I did. And see what else is. Oh, they had that same one that's got them big old, I did a video on them 20 ton plate clamps. It was in one of my videos. Now they gave me the PO for that yesterday. And them things was, I was just doing two clamps to rebuild, about $8,000. So that wasn't too shabby. Of course, the new plate clamps like that were probably, I can't remember now. It's $7,000-$8,000 for a new one. So, you know, he saved a few thousand dollars there, can't he? So, anyway. Well, I don't know what else to ramble about. So, I guess we'll cut it off here. And if I get to the shop.
Watch out, vehicle on shoulder ahead.
See what I mean? We'll get to the shop. I'll see what else we may have. And if I do have anything worth filming, I'll film it. Or it ain't really filming now, is it? It's ain't no film involved anymore. Can you even buy film? No, it's I guess they call it vlogging. It's a I know the V part's video and I don't vlog. I don't know. Somebody else will probably tell me what exactly that means, but that's what they call it. Anyway, I'm out of here.